Well, a test match has got ups and downs. That's why it's called a test match. It keeps testing you for 5 days. And over these 3 days, I think the Zimbabwe boys have fought well. They're still in the hunt. And some very good bowling by John Nyumbu. Great fielding. And the skipper leading from the front with the bat. And senior baseman Hamilton contributing. Yes, all in all, I think after 10 months without playing test cricket, we're back and playing against number one in the world. I think the boys have acquitted themselves well so far. And we still got another 2 days to fight. Well, yes, we lost Hamilton. Hamilton is one of the 7 batters. So there's still another 6 specialist guys to come. And there's still a lot of time in the game, 2 days. And we're looking to bat the whole day tomorrow. And a quarter of the day 5 and put a score. The wicket is jumping and turning, and it will be interesting. South Africa batting last, it will be very interesting. It just reminds me of Pakistani chasing 250. So yes, there's a lot to play for.
So South Africa need 10, you've got the man.
Hopefully he keeps turning it, which he has shown us that he can do. No, I'm not surprised at all. I think I give credit to my bowlers. They stuck to their disciplines. They know their strength and their weakness. They are not 145 bowlers. They are medium pacers, and they strapped their lines very well all day, very well disciplined. And it was always going to be difficult for anybody to score when guys bowl line and length all day without changing anything. So I think it's not a case that South Africa didn't bat well, but the Zimbabweans just bowled well, superbly. Panyangara, who bowled, I think his figures are phenomenal. You know, 30 overs for 31 runs. And well supported by Tendai Chatara, 28 overs, 37 runs, I think around there. So it just shows you the tight lines the guys bowled, really.